Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's look at using semi-transparent overlays in iMovie. So I'm using iMovie version 10 here, and what I'm going to show you is how to create semi-transparent overlays. Overlays are graphics that go over the video and you can see through them. And this allows you to put all sorts of things on the screen, like say arrows or circle items or put your own custom titles or just about anything you want on top. So in order to do this, we need to go into an image editing tool and create a semi-transparent image. I am going to use Pixelmator. It's a pretty inexpensive, easily accessible tool for Mac users. You can use Photoshop or anything else. But the key is that you want to create a new document. You want to make it the same size as your video. In this case, it's a 720p video, so 1280 by 720. This was a 1080 video. I would make it 1920 by 1080. For the best quality, it's best to have something the same size. And in Pixelmator, after I created it, see, I have a white background. I don't want a white background. I want a transparent background. So I'm going to change that, and you can see the checkerboard pattern representing transparency. Now I'm going to draw here on the screen, and I could do anything I want. I could create some shapes here. Let's go ahead and create an arrow. Let's use this arrow right here. And you can see the document is transparent. I just have the shape here across it. I can add some text as well if I want. I could create a circle, whatever it is I want to do. So I'm going to take this arrow here, and I know that in the video, say there's something I want to point to that's right here. So I'm going to create this. I'm going to save. Actually, I'm going to export it. And I want to export it as a PNG file, which is a file format that can contain transparency. JPEG and GIF and other formats don't do that. So I want to go and use PNG. And if you're saving it in a program that has lots of options, you want to make sure it's a 32-bit semi-transparent PNG file. This won't work if you save it and it's got a solid background. So I'm just going to call it arrow and save it to a folder in my documents folder. So here I am back in iMovie, and what I want to do is I want to drag and drop this in there. So in other docs I've got this arrow.png, and I can drag and drop it on top of, I want to make it an overlay. So I want to put it on top of the video like that. And now it'll take a few seconds for it to render, but I'll see that semi-transparent arrow appear just like that. And you can see that the video shows through because the rest of the image there is transparent, not with a solid color. If you see a solid color like white or black behind the arrow, that means you didn't successfully create a semi-transparent image using your graphics program. Now here I'm back in Pixelmator. I'm going to get rid of this arrow here, and instead I'm going to create a circle, and I'm going to create a very large circle like that. I'm going to set the fill color to be none and the stroke here to be a pretty thick line and make it something bright like that. So now I've got kind of a circle, and I'm still at 1280 by 720. I'm going to save this out. I'm going to export this as a PNG, and I'm going to call it circle. So now we're going to bring this circle graphic in here, and just by dragging and dropping it onto the video. And we could see it here. Now notice it's moving. That's because by default the Ken Burns effect is being applied to this graphic here. The same problem is happening with the arrow. So we could turn that off easily enough. I'm going to go to adjust, and I'm going to go to cropping here, and I've got several different options. I don't want to use fit. What's going to happen with fit is it's going to take the semi-transparent object and it's going to make it opaque. So you can see now it's black like that. So I don't want to do that. I want to go and instead use crop. And what crop will do is it will make this object work just fine, and you can see it won't animate, it won't change. It'll just appear there. And I could even go in and add some fade to it as well. So now it will fade in slowly over several frames. But the idea behind this circle here is I want to make it where I can point to something. So right now it just covers the entire graphic. So what I want to do is I want to change it from cutaway to picture in picture. And you can see now it's just a smaller image here on the upper right. And the cool thing is I could drag this around and put it where I want. So if there's something I want to circle, I can put it there. Now I can't change its ratio. You see, it's still, I can't make it thinner or taller or anything like that. So I made this into an oval like this. I could have made it into a circle for the middle if that's what I wanted. But here's an oval and I can change it and I could stretch it and put it where I want. And I could reuse that throughout this movie and other movies as well as something, some way to circle items. You could do the same thing with an arrow or some other shape or text.